like so. I'll pull on this literally as hard as I possibly can. And I'm not that strong, but I just want to show you. Doesn't even budge. Today, we're gonna go over a Munter hitch. Now, the Munter hitch is one of my favorite knots of all time. It's a burn knot that you can also use to bind around an object, and under load, a lot of tension, you can burn something off if you need to. Rock climbers use it a lot because of the aspect of it's a burn knot. And we use it all the time because, I mean, you can tie it around an object and then under load and tension, you can burn something off if you need to. A lot of people use it on carabiners for rigging. And so you can just put the rope in like so and then come around with it. You don't even need a tail really to do this. And then you have the Munter hitch right there. Now, to complete it, I always throw in a minimum of a 1/2 hitch. Most of the time, 2 if I have tail, right? So, you can pull on this sucker like a lot, and it's not gonna come undone. When you do want it to come undone, you just take out your 1/2 hitch, take out your next 1/2 hitch, and then you can keep tension on your tail, and then with this tension pulling it, the knot, you can, with the tail, give it some slack and you can burn this off. See, like I'm pulling this side as hard as I can, and I'm just barely giving it some slack this way. Now when I let go, you can just pull the whole knot out. So it's a great burn knot, and that's essentially what we use the Munter hitch for all the time. It's also just a kind of a strong, nice, secure little knot to use. You know, you could use it like a clove hitch or whatever else, but I don't know, it's a very easy hitch knot to tie. So on a carabiner, it doesn't matter, you could tie this around any object. So you don't even technically need a tail of the rope. You just need a bite of rope. So you can slip it into the carabiner like so. Gonna make it look like that. And then there you have your Munter hitch, and then just tie in a couple half hitches on the fall line right here. There's one. See, if you don't have, if you have a very long tail, you can just use a bite of rope and tie half hitches. There's two. And there is a Munter hitch with a couple half hitches that will hold the doggone world. So you just take out your half hitch is, pull this out and keep some tension on it. And as you're pulling that way, you can just feed it a little bit and it burns off. Nice and easy. So that's why the Munter hitch is great. Now, if you don't have a carabiner or whatever, you can always just obviously go like so, bring it around, come back up through. That's what a Munter hitch looks like. That's a Munter hitch. Just tie in a half hitch. Another half hitch to hold the world. And you have a complete Munter hitch. So, Munter hitch. Half hitch, half hitch, and there you have it. That's the Munter hitch. And then burn it off. Step one, put it on your object, go like that. Step two, go like that. That's your Munter hitch. Tie in a half hitch and another half hitch to secure it, and there you have a Munter hitch. Well, I hope you can learn how to tie a Munter hitch. As you could see, it's very easy to tie. One of the best applications if you need a burn knot one of the best knots to tie, well, hitch. So hopefully you can learn how to tie it, practice it. You know, I kind of showed you a couple applications of how it works, so kind of give you a better understanding of the hitch itself. Obviously, when you get to work out in the field, you're gonna see these knots that I teach, how they actually work in the field. It's kind of hard to teach them in my backyard because I'm not building power lines back here, and it's kind of hard to show you exactly how we use them out there. And that's something you'll learn out in the field, but at least if you know the knot and you know how to tie it, then when your lineman or whoever, your superior tells you, hey, tie me a bowline or a clove hitch or a Munter hitch or a bowline on a bite or square knot, you know how to tie it and you're not fumbling. My biggest thing is practice tying them around something, because it's easy to tie a knot in front of you. Once you need to tie it something around horizontally or around something vertically, it's a little bit different application. So I would also say, you know, practice it in many different ways possible. So there's the Munter hitch. Hopefully you learned from it. Thanks for watching.